torn bugs in autumn and freshly cut cornfields. One arm out the window and one hand on the wheel. Some things just go better together and probably always will. Like a cup of coffee and the sunrise. Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this on guitar if it ain't got no strings? Or pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer and me, as long as you're right here. Your license in my wallet when we go out downtown. Your lipstick stained every coffee cup that I got in this house. The way you say I love you too is like rain on an old tin roof. And your hand fits right into mine like a needle in a groove. Some things just go better together.
Gather in this place to witness and to celebrate as you dedicate yourselves one to the other to a lifelong commitment here before God, your family, and your friends. Marriage is a journey. It will cherish the past, hope for the future, and provide the gift of the present to help you share, grow, and enrich every area of your life. Today is the beginning of that journey. As you travel on this journey, you will need God's supporting strength to bring you through. So I think it's appropriate that we invite him right now to be a part of this commitment that you're making to each other. Let's pray together. God, we know that today is not a surprise to you. The Bible teaches us that you know every day of our life, God. And you knew this day would come for Logan and Heather. And God, we celebrate that. But we also find confidence in that, in knowing, God, that you already knew this day would be here. So I pray that you've already been forming and shaping and putting into their lives, God, the things that they're going to need to walk this journey together. And God, we know the greatest need that we all have is always your presence. And so we invite you as a significant party to be here today, God, to bless this union, God. And we ask that you will walk with them through this journey of life. And God, may you be a blessing to them, but also may you be a comfort and encouragement in everything that they do. And we're going to thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Sooner or later, we begin to understand that love is more than just verses on Valentine's and romance in movies. We begin to know that love is here and now, real and true, the most important thing in our lives. For love is the creator of our favorite memories and the foundation of our fondest dreams. Without love, we merely exist. But with love, we truly begin to live. For love is a promise that is always kept, and a fortune that can never be spent, a seed that can flourish in even the most unlikely place. And this radiance that never fades, this mysterious and magical joy, is the greatest treasure of all. We are together as friends, relatives, and families to recognize a new beginning, which for Logan and Heather serves as a public affirmation of their friendship and their love. Someone once said, the most wonderful of all things in life is the discovery of another human being with whom one's relationship has a growing depth, beauty, and joy as the years increase. This inner progressiveness of love between two human beings is a most marvelous thing, and it can or cannot be found by looking for it or by passionately wishing for it. It's a divine destiny. The Word of God teaches us in Ecclesiastes, he inspired these words to Solomon to write, two are better than one because they have a good return for their work. If one falls down, his friend can help him up. But pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. And here's the punchline. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do. Her and her mother. Myself and her mother.
All right. All right. Logan, will you have Heather to be your wife, to live with her, respect her, and love her as God intends, with the promise of faithfulness, tenderness, and helpfulness, as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I do.
I do.
All right. And Heather, will you have Logan to be your husband, to live with him, respect him, and love him as God intends, with the promise of faithfulness, tenderness, and helpfulness, as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I do.
I do.
All right. Now, Logan, I'll ask you to repeat after me, all right? I, Logan, take you, Heather.
I, Logan, take you, Heather.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
To honor and to cherish you.
To honor and to cherish you.
And to share my thoughts.
To share my thoughts.
Hopes.
Hopes.
And dreams with you.
And dreams with you.
I will love you without reservation.
I will love you without reservation.
Comfort you in times of need.
Comfort you in times of need.
Encourage you to achieve.
Encourage you to achieve.
All your goals.
All your goals.
I will laugh with you.
I will laugh with you.
Cry with you.
Cry with you.
And grow with you.
And grow with you.
In mind and in spirit.
In mind and in spirit.
I pledge you the rest of my life.
I pledge you the rest of my life.
As your husband and friend.
As your husband and friend.
Good job. Sure. All right, Heather, it's your turn. I, Heather, take you, Logan.
I, Heather, take you, Logan.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
To honor and to cherish you.
To honor and to cherish you.
And to share my thoughts.
To share my thoughts.
Hopes.
Hopes.
And dreams with you.
With you.
I will love you without reservation.
I will love you without reservation.
Comfort you in times of need.
Comfort you in times of need.
Encourage you to achieve.
Encourage you to achieve.
All of your goals.
All of your goals.
I will laugh with you.
I will laugh with you.
Cry with you.
Cry with you.
And grow with you.
And grow with you.
In mind and in spirit.
In mind and in spirit.
I pledge you the rest of my life.
I pledge you the rest of my life.
As your wife and friend.
As your wife and friend.
Awesome. Awesome. Now, will each of you seal your sacred vow by giving of a ring and pledge that you will faithfully perform your vows? Say, we will.
We will.
All right. Do we have?
I thought that was
there for you. It's awesome. Awesome. Thank you so much. Now, Logan and Heather, these rings are a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. So love freely given has no beginning and no end. These rings mark the beginning of your journey together. So wear them proudly, for they are symbols which speak of the love that you have for one another. May your rings be a constant reminder of this moment when you have pledged your unending love to one another. So Logan, I'll ask you to place this ring on Heather's finger and repeat after me as you do. Heather, with this ring.
Heather, with this ring.
I take you to be.
I take you to be.
My trusted soulmate.
My trusted soulmate.
And partner for life.
And partner for life.
Take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a sign of my faith.
As a sign of my faith.
And my commitment.
And my commitment.
To our love.
To our love.
And let us walk together always.
And let us walk together always.
Awesome. Great, great. Now, Heather. Logan, with this ring.
Logan, with this ring.
I take you to be.
I take you to be.
My trusted soulmate.
My trusted soulmate.
And partner for life.
And partner for life.
Take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a sign of my faith.
As a sign of my faith.
And my commitment.
And my commitment.
To our love.
To our love.
And let us walk together always.
And let us walk together always.
Amen. All right. Now we're going to do the candle, okay?
Okay.
Hand on the light. There you go. Logan and Heather, you are now entering into that holy estate of matrimony, which is the deepest mystery of a human experience and a type of Christ's love for the church. Your lighted candles are a symbol of your individual lives, each with its own personality and interest. But marriage is an act of loving surrender. You no longer go your separate ways as you bring the flames of your candles together. You're now lighting the candle of a larger and fuller life. Your lives are fused as one, and they shall be one flesh. Now each of you must blow out the candle, which represents your individual life. For the sake of the light, which represents your lives together. In giving up, you have received. In losing your identity, you take on the identity of each other. And through this act, you will find the fullness and purpose for living. In the home you are establishing, let the flame of your true love burn brightly, and the love of God's light shine undiminished in your life. Let's pray. God, we thank you for this decision and this choice today that Logan and Heather have made together. And God, they have just lit a single candle. And we know, God, that the Bible teaches us we become one. But we know that's a journey and a process. So we pray that you will walk with them in every decision that they make in life, every choice, God, every opportunity they are given. God, we just pray that your blessing will rest upon it. May their first thought be about you and what you would have them do. And we're going to thank you for that. And Lord, as they walk through life and as different experiences happen to them along this journey, We pray that you will be present in all of those experiences, God. May they sense you and feel you. And may they know, God, that you are the common denominator of their relationship, God, holding them together, Lord, with trust and love and great communication and wonderful respect for each other. And we're going to thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. The Apostle Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians in chapter 13, he penned these words. These are great words to remember for the rest of your lives and your journey together. And if you ever want to know what love is, check out this verse. It says love is patient. Sometimes it's difficult for us, but we have to work at it. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy, and it does not boast. It is not proud. And it is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. And it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always hopes, always trusts, and always perseveres. Love never fails. Logan and Heather, since you've promised your love to each other in the presence of God and these witnesses and have exchanged vows of commitment to one another and rings, I pronounce that you are husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no one separate. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Logan, in just a second, you can kiss your bride. All right, that's probably one of the best kisses I've seen at a. That's good, very good, very good. All right, I'm going to ask you to face everybody if you will. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to present to you for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Logan Simpson.
Gentlemen, while the wedding party is taking some more pictures, you're invited over to the patio.